Coming to you from our GIS studios, I am Lucia Antoine, and this is your Midday News Brief. Meet Julie and Sean, the couple who took their love for scuba diving to the next level by taking the plunge, literally, in an underwater wedding. The couple's wedding features prominently as the highlight of St. Lucia's Dive Festival 2019. The idea was brought to the fore when travel agent Julie Gilchrist participated in the 2018 Dive Fest. The wedding was officiated by diver attached to the Tikai Resort and Spa, Lester Lawrenson. The St. Lucia Tourism Authority continues to promote dive as another niche in addition to romance, culinary adventure, family, health and wellness, and sports. Newlyweds Julie Gilchrist and Sean Gillan's wedding represents a merger between the romance and dive niches. Dive Fest 2019 encompassed a number of activities, including a dive treasure hunt, lionfish derby, photo seminar and competition, themed dinners, street fiestas, and island tours. The third annual St. Lucia Dive Festival was hosted by the St. Lucia Divers Association and the St. Lucia Tourism Authority. Dive Fest 2019 commenced on September 8th and culminated on September 15th. The Bahamas Protected Areas Fund, BPAF, a sister fund of the St. Lucia National Conservation Fund, has appealed for donations to support recovery efforts within the Bahamas. The mandate of the NCF, like the BPAF, is also to provide grants for conservation, sustainable development, and climate and disaster resilience in St. Lucia. Thus, the board approved a small grant to assist the BPAF with its community-based disaster efforts. During the restoration process and in keeping with its mandate, the BPAF will give local grants to support for assessments to determine the impacts of Hurricane Dorian on ecosystem health, restoration of impacted protected areas, and other initiatives related to ecosystem recovery following Hurricane Dorian. The BPAF will also support the provision of water purification systems and renewable energy initiatives for communities in Abaco and Grand Bahama. A non-profit organization focused on empowering rural women is continuing to positively impact the lives of women in the agriculture sector. Since 2016, Helen's Daughters has been making a case for the economic development of rural women through improved market access, adaptive agricultural techniques, and capacity building. The latest initiative undertaken by the organization is a Rural Women's Academy. The organization's president says that while it does take some time to get to rural women, partner organizations have made the process a lot easier. Helen's Daughters was developed out of a winning proposal for UN Women's Empower Women Champions for Change program. This has been your Midday News Brief. Thank you for watching.